They did use different colors.
只是到了这个明元代以后，逐渐的水墨用的多了一些。
After Yuan Dynasty, they start use more and more only these inks and water.
这种变化的原因呢，就是因为中国的宋朝以后呢，是由少数民族统治了中国。
This is because after Song Dynasty, China was ruled by ethnic minorities.
有很多这种文人呢和这种汉人呢不太服气，所以用绘画来进行一些反抗。
汉人反抗，他们反抗。
汉人反抗少数民族。
汉 majorities were suppressed, and they used this type of simple painting to protest ethnic minority rulers.
最有代表性的就应该是明末清初时期的这个八大山人叫朱大。
The most well known period was during the end of the Ming Dynasty, transition from Ming Dynasty to Qing Dynasty. As you know, Qing Dynasty was Manchus. And so the most famous artists are eight mountain people, mountain artists.
那么他的绘画作品呢，最后主要是以墨不用色就直接去绘画。
So they start using only inks and water.
因为他是一个明朝的一个后裔，那么他不服从这个清朝的不满清朝的统治，所以他就不用颜色去画画，全用墨去画画。
And that's one way to express their protest against the Qing Dynasty, because they are from Ming Dynasty. Try to use this.
也就是他呢，把中国这种水墨的这种表现的技法达到了一个极致。
That's the peak of the expression of the ink and water painting in the Chinese history.
而且，也就是技巧是最强的。
That time, the techniques were mostly required.
对，他的每一笔都有他的一个意义，就是没有什么很重复的东西。
Every straw has a meaning. There's no repetition.
画面都很简洁。
All those paintings are very simple.
而且这种绘画风格呢，一直影响到现在。
And that style has influenced.Until today,
到现在我们中国的这个水墨界，就是国画里面也有人很推崇这种画方。
Even today in the Chinese water, counter, water, ink painting, community, a lot of people still think this is the best.
把不用颜色来画画的，认为是最好的会做。
Without colors, just use one black ink.They think this is the best painting.
其实我认为我们现在的生活都很丰富多彩，还是用颜色表现出来，大家更喜欢。
But in his personal view, he thinks our lives are very, very colorful today. So we might need some more colors to express them.
当然，研究一些中国笔墨技巧方面的来讲，他还是可以是一个典范，学习的典范。
But still, to learn the techniques of the painting, they are still the examples. Set examples.
那么我们现在在这个大陆中国在普及这种绘画的时候，也用的是他的这种方法。
Today in China, for the popular painting education, they still use the simple way.
因为他主要是以这个花草和动物鸟之类的东西来表现它的那思想。
Because this is just use flowers, grass, and animals to express themselves.
而就是我们说的叫花鸟画。
So that's the what we call bird, flower and bird paintings.
而这些画这些表现的物种呢，也是我们生活当中。经常见到的东西。
Those are what we see in the daily lives.
而且呢，他把他这些东西可以 赋予很多的意义。
So they give meanings to those daily lives.
我们所以我们现在这个中国这种水墨画表现的比较多一点的，很多就是叫竹子，兰花，菊花、梅花这类的东西。
So the most often you see are the bamboo and these are several types of flowers. I don't think I know how to say them.
而且往往这些作品呢又流传到海外。
So these paintings have been shipped to overseas.
因为它可能很容易被人接受。
Because they are easy to be accepted by overseas people.
而且呢可能画起来呢就相对简单一些。
And also it's easy to draw them.
那么表现这些东西这些作品这些题材的人呢就是在现代来讲应该是齐白石作为一个代表。
The representative of this type of painting is 齐白石 very old guy.
他就是表现他小的时候看到的和接触到的东西和生活当中的东西啊，比如说小虫子白菜或者什么瓜等等。
So he starts from his young childhood what he saw, like the insects, like mantis, like those grass. He just started painting those very simple stuff.
那么随着我们这个年纪的人呢，就要去走入现实当中去写生，去搞一些创作，可以吧？所以说。
So at our age, his age, he said, we want to go to real life to learn from real life to paint.
用传统的这种笔墨的这种技法来表现我们现实生活当中所见到的东西。
So we try to use the traditional style to express the real life we see.
比如说我这次带来的作品就是。
Paintings he brought.This time, all are those in the daily life he saw.
这次我带来这些作品呢，有画的很工细的部分，也有画的比较写意的部分。
There are different types of paintings he brought. In some of them are very rough. Did not spend a lot of time carefully. Some of them are very carefully painted.
内容上的题材也比较多。
And the subjects are also variety.
我想呢，能通过我的这些作品呢，能反映一下我们现在中国绘画的一个基本的状况。
So these paintings reflect, he hope, a very basic situation of Chinese paintings in China today.
也是我这次来宣传一下中国的文化。
That's the purpose of to let people.Learn about Chinese culture. Okay, thank you.
Is that
very well? Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.